Okay, let's talk about cyclohexane rings. Often, when you're looking at some diagrams of cyclohexane rings, you'll see some drawn as hexagons, like I've drawn here. Now, after our discussion on conformation isomers, you should recognize that this is not a very good drawing. The reason why is because when you add in all of the hydrogen atoms, as I have here, if you were to look at a Newman projection along any pair of carbon atoms in the ring, you'll notice that all of the hydrogen atoms are eclipsed. And as we've discussed, the eclipsed conformation is high in energy and is unstable. Another issue you might have noticed is, if you look at this diagram, you'll notice that all of the carbons are sp3 hybridized. sp3 hybridized atoms have a tetrahedral electronic geometry and should have bond angles close to 109.5 degrees. However, if you look at these bond angles within this hexagon, you'll recognize it's also not 109.5 degrees. So here, also want to note, you have the wrong bond angles. So this of course means that actual molecules with a six-membered rings do not exist as a plane, right? It's not just a flat ring. What actually exists is the chair conformation, which you're likely familiar from your organic chemistry classes. A chair conformation looks like this, where you can see the six members are not in the same plane, right? And what's good about this conformation is, first of all, we can go ahead and draw in all of the hydrogen atoms. You're going to notice here that I'm drawing the hydrogen atoms in two colors, and for a specific reason. Now, the first thing I want us to take note of is, if you take a look at all the hydrogen atoms within the chair conformation, you're going to notice that they are now all staggered, right? Much more stable. So here we can say all hydrogen atoms are staggered. And if you look at the bond angles, you also have your 109.5 degrees bond angles that you expect for sp3 hybridized atoms. Another thing that I want to point out is that, yes, this chair conformation looks much better than the planar shape that we drew earlier, but for the MCAT, you also need to be aware that these substituent orientations, there are two types. The ones in red are called axial positions. The one in blue are called equatorial positions. So I'm going to make a note here that here in red, we have axial hydrogens. And here in blue, we have equatorial hydrogens. This is important because there's a concept related to the stability of large substituents on cyclohexane rings. And it's about 1,3 diaxial interactions. So here, if I have this cyclohexane ring, if I don't draw anything else, it's just six hydrogens, so it doesn't really matter where the hydrogens are. However, if you were to add a large substituent, for instance, let's say we were to add a methyl group. And here, the methyl group is axial. The problem with having an axial is that if this is carbon one, then two carbons away is carbon three. But you can also count two carbons in the opposite direction. So here's another hydrogen on carbon three. And these groups are all axial. And when you have a large substituent, they're close enough to each other that you have steric interactions. So this is what we refer to as the 1,3 diaxial interactions. And this is unfavorable, all right? So we can make a note here that 1,3 diaxial interactions are unfavorable. The good news, however, is when you have a substituent that is axial, it is possible for you to do a chair flip. So what I mean is that here, this ring can actually flip. And when it flips, the positions of all the atoms that are axial become equatorial, and all the substituents that are equatorial now become axial. So after doing the flip, your methyl group would now take on an equatorial position. And in this equatorial position, it no longer has 1,3-diaxial interactions. So the main point for you to know here and for the MCAT is all large substituents must be in the equatorial position. And this is actually a helpful strategy for MCAT questions, because if you see different answer choices that look similar, if you take a notice that in some of the answer choices, a large substituent is in an axial position, you can definitely eliminate that answer choice.